morning from Latrobe Magnesium is David Paterson. David, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to see you, David.
Talk to you again.
This binding term sheet here, $23 million in project funding, a critical step for you. Tell us a bit more about it.
Well, it's actually $23 million plus capitalised interest, so a lot of the time for starters. So we have capitalised interest through the whole of our construction period, which is our 1,000 tonner plus our 10,000 tonner. So that's a very good solution for us when we're not earning a lot of income. So and the security for it is mainly the research and development rebate. We expect to receive probably $14 million over that period to help pay back that $20 million. There's $3 million in standby credit facility, which is just in case we go over our $39 million costs, which we don't believe we will. But in case we do, we have a $3 million capacity to bring that home. In that $39 million, there is already $3 million contingency. So we've sort of got contingency on contingency. So we hope we won't have to draw that.
So as far as construction, David, what are you now funded for?
We're funded for the whole for the initial plant. And then we believe, because of the recent allocation of funds to critical raw materials from the federal government of $2 billion, that we will be able to access those funds for the expansion out of to the 10,000 ton plant, which will basically be seamless. So the first demonstration plant gets up in January 23, and then projected for the 10,000 to be up and operational in January 24. And that's all been mapped out, what needs to be done.
How's work as far as the PFS here?
Sorry, yes, the 100. What we've decided to do is start a pre-feasibility study. We've done a lot of concept work on our ferro nickel slag, and this is a way of basically fulfilling demand that's come to us over this time, over the China issues of shortage, because our 10,000 ton is spoken for of material with our current two offtakes. And as I think I've mentioned previously, we've had about 20 plus thousand in the last few months. So what we're looking to do is build that in joint venture with a partner that needs magnesium, so an aluminium type partner who will probably take an offtake somewhere up to 40,000 tonnes, and we only have to sell 60 to the market, which is crying out for at the moment. Of course, there is no supply still. So we thought that's the way we can satisfy the demand requirements that are sitting there, if we can bring that forward. And we think we could get that up and operational by 2026. So it's pre-feas because we have two sites for it, and then we'll go straight into the bankable once we've determined which partner and which sites.
Just remind us, David, as far as the technology, it allows for a relatively low operating cost here, does it?
Yeah, it's when you get the economies of scale. I mean, at 10,000, we can compete with China. At 100,000, we're a lot. We're probably nearly even half the operating costs of China. So, I mean, there's some big steps there. But based on the work that we've done and all the laboratory work and the testing, it should hold up. So, I mean, the numbers on the 10,000 ton plant, you know, $110 million of revenue, $42 million of EBITDA. There's some pretty solid numbers there, and that's looking at old pricing of magnesium, not the fancy pricing today of $6,500 US a ton, which would be ridiculous if you were doing that. But we believe China's going to be around for, you know, most of 2022. The supply chain issues are coming out now with other materials as well. So we think it's going to be around for a while. That's why we thought best to start engaging with people that want significant amounts of mag, so we can get their focus while things are still tight.
And as far as 2022, David, what are the key priorities which you're looking to achieve next year?
Well, we're looking to achieve completion of the 1,000 ton plant. We're talking still September, we get it up, 3 months to commission. So we talk January 23 on start production. We will have our financing done and our feasibility done on the 10,000, so that'll be put to bed. So we can go, once we operate the plant the demo plant for probably 3 months. We will then be able to go straight into increasing production there. And we would hope by the end of 2022, we'll have also our partner, we'll be starting our feasibility study. That's bankable feasibility study, not the pre-feas, that we can get through that fairly quickly, we believe, beginning of the year. That's with a tier one player as well, EPCM contractor. So they're the sort of the major milestones we look to achieve. But, you know, don't take the eye off the ball. It's all about the demonstration plan first and the other two to follow. And, you know, we bought the building over the weekend, effectively, that we had on a fixed price contract for the last 9 years. So we think we bought it well. Its locality at the moment is right next to a solar renewable power station that's getting built, a 70 megawatt one, which wraps around it, probably 500 meters away. The beauty about that is if we can tune into that, it's going to be 70 megawatts and a solar battery. It's been approved by the council. It's sitting with the state minister at the moment. For the 10,000 ton plant, we only need 15 megawatts. So that's a 20% requirement. So I think that's a very doable transaction, but we'll have to engage with those parties over the next 12 months. And if we can do that, then we talk about zero CO2 emissions in our plant. I mean, with our reduction in capital costs, we've also reduced our CO2 emissions from the 10 tons that we've talked previously down to 7.5. So that's a significant improvement in both CapEx and CO2 emissions. And we're looking to get that down further, as I said, with vertical retorts and also renewables in the 10,000 ton plant. So we'll probably go positive if you look at it on a life cycle analysis for the plant tons, which is, you know, a great step forward for the business and the industry. It'll be definitely a world beater in the industry.
Clearly a big year ahead for you. David, nice to see you. Thanks very much.
Okay, thanks, Andrew.